So this is the Geeky Minecrafter, and today I'm going to be streaming some improvements that I'm going to be making on the Golden XP farm that I just finished building. Now, if you've been following along, there's several videos on creating this, and I got to tell you, wow, it was kind of a challenge. So give me a second to tool up here. Let's see what we have. I'm not going to need this wood or the wool or the andesite. I'm just going to leave that here. I've got some extra buckets. You know, I think that's going to do it. Now, what are we going to need down at the XP farm? I think I'm going to need some additional granite. I've got some dark oak. Oh, good grief, what's going on here? I'm going to need some glass, I'm going to need some dark oak, I'm going to need some granite. And with those three things, I think we can kind of tie it in. Let's see, I think the dark oak is down here. Right. Yeah, right here. So we'll take like a few of those, and then let's go see how much glass I have. I don't think I have a whole lot of glass. I haven't been out to a desert in a while. I haven't found a whole bunch of sand, so I think I just have, well, let's see. Yeah, that's not going to be enough. Okay, well, part of this stream may be maybe us going to find some sand. We may have an exploration part of this stream today. So if you're just joining, I'm the Geeky Minecrafter. I'm Minecraft Gran, and I'm definitely a little bit on the geeky side. I do like automating things. I do like building things. Like, there's my iron golem farm, and it's awesome while I'm out here in the world doing anything. It doesn't matter if I'm in the Nether, doesn't matter if I'm down here at the XP farm, if I'm over there at the mob farm, doesn't matter where I'm at. The iron golem farm is busy producing iron for me. As a matter of fact, we'll check that in just a few minutes. Let's just get a few things done down here. I'm racing the sun. So we're going to get down here. This is a single player world. And I am the only one online at the moment. Now, I say single player, I'm sorry, it's a multiplayer world, but I'm the only one online. Raven, my granddaughter, and JD Naz, a friend of mine, also play on this server with me. Now, before you ask, it is a private server that I set up for just we three. Although I have some ambitions to maybe create a full-blown server that we can play on. I have to tell you, I have been enjoying like Cherry Vanilla. It's a lot of fun to play with other people, but I don't know that I necessarily want the headaches. Okay, so here is the finished Golden XP farm. Now I have a couple of entrances. Turns out as I was sitting in here, I went AFK down in the lower area and came back to the keyboard and all my doors were gone. Apparently, some zombies had come in, you know, come in through here. I didn't have fence at the time. They'd come in through here. They knocked down the door. Then they they walked downstairs. They knocked down this door to try and get to me. Now, fortunately, I had the forethought to kind of brick myself in. I was in here. I had some glass blocks right here, so nobody could get to me. But, you know, if I hadn't bricked in, I'd have come back and my person had been dead and all my stuff had been probably despawned. Okay, so let's take a look at what we have here. I think I have a view right over here. Come here. I have a view right over here. So there are the three interior rings. Hi, Missy Moon. How are you? There are the three interior rings. And what happens is because they're so tall and they're so wide, zombie pigmen spawn in, and because it's only four off the ground and there's water underneath them, they'll step off. They'll step off, they'll be flowed down to what I'm calling my kill chamber. Now I'm going to go ahead and close this. Okay, right now it's set for if I'm not here. So if I flip this switch, see how I get a pad here, they can drop in and I can click this button and it will crush them. Now I don't have quite enough repeaters in there. Let me show you what I have. Ooh, is it? I think it's here. Okay. See, I have repeaters that go all the way down. It's just not quite enough of a delay. Zombie pigmen have, like, I don't know, 20 hearts, which means, you know, they can stand up to 40 worth of damage. So I need to extend that. And I'm trying to think where I put those extra repeaters. Hello? Repeaters, can you hear me? Probably not. Where else do I have some? Maybe. Look at all the swords I'm getting. And the gold. Now, I've converted a lot of the ingots into gold. I'm sorry, a lot of the nuggets into gold ingots. And then I have some down here. Again, this is my AFK station. It will just collect them automatically. And look at all of this. Isn't that sweet? Thanks, Missy. I'm glad you're enjoying it. I've had a lot of fun building it. I am out of repeaters, and I don't want to go to the house. Okay, well, let me show you what happens when you aggro these guys. You know, I need somebody to step in the water. Come on, guys, step down. Come on, it'll be fun. You'll enjoy it. Yes, Missy Moon, there is a lot of work in this world. This particular build took 3 videos worth, actually 5 if you count the 2 that didn't record, and several Minecraft days. Now, I cleared all this out, I leveled it all up, I built up, and died several times falling off this thing. Come on. Fall down, just one guy, and then I can make them all come down. Do I have any snowballs? Really? Come on, guys, come on. Work with me. Let's see. No, nobody. Let's see if there's maybe one down here. No. I just need one. Oh, there is, there is. Here we go. Ready to aggro them? Here they all come. Now, here's the sad part. The little one high zombie pigman can get out of here. So you gotta be on guard. Oops, see, here we come. You gotta be on guard because they can get through here. Let's see, let's go punch him one more time. See if I can't get that guy to drop down. Here we go. Okay, so let me show you what it does. You click this and it crushes them, and it does it all the way down to pretty close to one hit, not quite one hit. That's why I want a few extra repeaters so that I can finish that. Do you see all the XP that came out there? Okay, got another sword. Got some more ingots. Got some more zombie flesh. So again, I wasn't down here very long. I didn't let them build up like I would normally do so. I would stay down here AFK for a while, and it'd really build them up. When I was first trying it out, I let them build up. I went AFK for about half an hour while I made dinner. I came back in. I aggroed them. They all ran down. They filled up that chamber. And what do you know? I went from like a level 17 to a level, I want to say 20, in just one session. So, you know, 3 levels worth of XP. I hate to do this. We're running really fast. I've got to have some more repeaters, some more nether quartz. Let's see, what's the recipe for repeaters again? It's is it 3 stone? I'm gonna have to look it up. That's embarrassing. If you know it. Sure. Okay. Thanks for checking in with me, Missy Moon. It's always a lot more fun to have somebody to interact with. Where's my list here? Now, I've been working on some technical difficulties. My OBS software and OpenGL, my NVIDIA drivers, they all tend to, want to crash. And I think part of the reason is because of I have a tool on my computer called Workshelf. And basically, I think it just kind of checks out. And when it does, the OpenGL can't recover, and it shuts all the drivers down, and I'm toast. It locks everything up, and I have to leave. Java shuts down, the whole nine yards. So, let's see. Here we go. Let's see. Obtaining is 3 pieces of stone, 2 redstone torches, and redstone. So I have all of those ingredients, but I'm just going to go make sure I have enough. How about that? Come on. Do you have as much trouble with ladders as I do? Because, good grief. Okay. Yeah, as you can see, I've used quite a few. Let's see. We're going to need... I'll take all the rest of those. Nope, not down there. I'll take a little more of this. Repeaters. Oh, I'm wrong. I had some. Never mind. Yeah, last time I sat down here and made up a bunch. I do like having, you know, more than I need. I do like being prepared. So let me see if I can get back down there before it gets dark. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go the long way, and I'm going to show you the Iron Golem farm. I hope you're back. If you are, let me know. If not, I guess you'll have to check out the video later. I'm standing out here like I've got good sense. Here we go. Okay, so I can't tell if you're in the room or not. This is the Iron Golem farm that I created. Each one of those pods contains about 30 villagers. There are 3 levels of doors, and as you can see, it produces quite a bit of iron. I'm really pretty fortunate. I told you I was having some technical difficulties. It just occasionally bails on me. There we go. All back. Let it rebuild the world. Good grief. Okay, apologize for that. Yeah, that's kind of what I've been dealing with here. If you're back, welcome back. I need to build a bridge over here, but I'm just going to take this shortcut. I hope you had a chance to see the Iron Golem farm and how much iron I'm pulling out of there. It is quite a bit. It makes it worth my while to go mining and to do other things in the world, and it's still producing iron for me. In fact, if I don't do a whole lot of mining, and I'm out here working in the world and building, I'm actually pulling in as much iron as if I were down there mining. So it's good stuff. And see, part of my next project is stairs right here, so I can get up here pretty easily without jumping. You know, move it, Mr. Cow, move. There, cooked meat. And more cooked meat. Okay, gotta love that. Gotta love a sword with fire aspect. Now, I'm really hoping that that little hiccup we just had did not corrupt my video file, which it has been doing in the past. Very disappointing. I'll be down here working. I'll get 3 or 4... you know, really good projects done, and it'll do that. It'll lock up and fall away, and I'm toast. Okay, so I probably ought to do this now while there are not a whole bunch spawned in. So let's see, where is the wood? Well, okay, let me just make some. And we got some glass, so I'm not going to need the shovel. What I'm hoping to do, I'm going to create an aggro station here, okay, and all of this is going to be glass. I'm probably going to put like a little balcony out here where I walk up and get on the balcony so I can shoot the ones that are up here. Again, my goal is to aggro them, so you can't aggro them if you can't see them. So I think this one's done, right? I emptied that. And see, I've got to do some work in here. If you were following the videos, basically what happened I built the whole thing, only to discover that I'm one too high. Actually, technically, I'm probably too high. I'm four above the ground, as I should be, but my channel here is only one deep, and technically, they can jump out of it. You know, when I got stuck in there, I was able to jump right out. Yes, I did crash and rebuilt it, so I'm back. Welcome back. Let me catch you up. Basically, what you missed was, besides the crash, I took you and showed you the Iron Golem farm, and we've discussed a little bit about some of the problems I've had here. Now, I am going to need to raise this floor one level in order to build the aggro station, in order to get this channel deeper, in order to be able to step it down. See, I'm using pressure plates, and they're hanging up on those. And that's fine as long as I can aggro them. They will all run towards me, but in the interim, you know, they just... Here, let me show you. Let me throw this guy. So he's just standing there on that pressure plate. Now, if I aggro him, here comes everybody. Okay, and they will drop down over there into that... Oh, my goodness. See, he... I need... I need to be a little bit higher for the aggro station. Oh, I thought he just jumped in there. Did you see that? Here, let's pull him in here with me. Including the little guys. Oh. Here, we'll close this off. I'll show you what's down there in just a minute. So, basically, this is my aggro station. This is, you know, how I get my XP. As it turns out, in this version, if you crush zombie pigmen, even if they die, they're going to give you the XP. So that was my goal, is, you know, to be able to press, crush them and get all the XP. See, here it all comes. Life is good. Okay, now I just put up the stuff I've collected. No swords. We'll put the gold in there. Again, what I'm showing you is really fast. I haven't given it time to warm up. I've just gotten down here. So with this switch flipped, here's what happens. I've got an AFK station right down here. So they'll fall down that hole. The water will flow them into the cactus. The cactus will kill them, and all of their goods will drop down in here. Okay. So when I'm not up here, when I'm not, you know, trying to build up the number of pigments so I get the XP, I just let them flow down there, so I don't have to worry about it. Now I'm gonna leave this up because I'm protected being outside this door. See, I can come out here and close this door and be protected. Now, I do need to move this. So, let's see. I'm going to need to lift this floor up too high. I think I have enough cobblestone for that. Yeah, let's just do it. Let's just do it. Let's put the wood up. Hello. It's good to meet you too. How you doing? How you doing? Okay, move it. I got work to do, buddy. we go. So this is now too high, so they should not be able to jump back out of it. I can scoop that water up, put it one higher, that'll help. And I need to do at least this first level one higher. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Water flow 7. So put the source block, oops, put the source block here. You know what I can do? Because they'll fall to the inside, right? Which way are they coming out? Hello? Can you hear me now? Goofball. Please step away from the hole. Thank you. Two more. Come on. Oh, thank you. Okay, now it's time for water. Now this part... this part always gets me. Now, here's what's going to happen. Let me just make sure this is closed, although... Oh, this could be bad. My crusher's not going to work with that block in the way. And I can't kill the zombie pigmen. Let's see, can I get that block? No. Okay, we're going to worry about that in a minute. Because the last thing I want is zombie pigmen falling on me. Okay, I have two waters. And I know it's possible to do this, although it is a bit scary. It will wash me away. I wish I had my Depth Strider boots right now. So, I'll come... Come on, guy. Really? Excuse me. Okay. Think they can get out. Oof. See, I can't believe I took them out of my inventory and put them in here. Oh, and I have a little guy wandering around in here, don't I? Yes, I do. Okay. Oh, this could be bad. See, right now he doesn't hate me. That could change really quickly. Okay, let's let him fall. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Oh, stop. Oh, this could be bad. This could be so bad. Oh, come on. Oh my goodness, stop. And they set me on fire and I don't have any water. Are you kidding me? Oh, yeah, this is bad. I got nothing. I got nothing. Oh, I got nothing. Come on. Come on. Oh, good grief. I've got nothing to even make tools with. All my stuff is down below. Oh, this could be bad. No food, no water, no arrows. And he's got like a truckload of hearts, right? Okay. Really? You don't see me. You don't see me. You don't see me. Close this door. Okay. Oh yeah, close this door too, because that's how they got in. Okay. Wow. Wow. Okay, let's take a moment, bow our heads, and thank all that is holy that that wasn't worse. I mean, I lost all my levels, that's bad, but it could have been so much worse. Oh my gosh. Hello. See, he's standing on a pressure plate. And that's fine when they're not aggroed. I don't mind if they stand there all day, but I will aggro them from time to time. I'm going to create a little station right up there, if I hadn't mentioned it already. A little balcony I could stand on where they can't reach me, but I can reach them. Let's pick this up. Let's go one higher. Nope. Okay, I am of the opinion they are not trying to kill me. So what is that? One, two, I don't know. We're going to go peek. I think I'm going to come in the side here. No, not this one. Oh, no, I'm going to need that handy. I'm going to need that handy. Oh, I hope I don't need the sword. That would be bad, right? If I need the sword again, I'm in trouble. Because it's going to be moving fast. Okay, nobody wants to kill me? Whew. Please continue. There is no one among you.
Thank you.
getting a little further, but they're still not... Oh my gosh. I'm gonna have to raise the rings. Or lower the contraption, one or the other. I've done everything in my power to avoid that, because let me show you why. This contraption, here, you guys just continue to build up there. This contraption involves a bunch of sticky pistons. It goes around, it goes down. Then there's the timing mechanism over here. This goes up into the crusher switch right there. It splits the signal off. It heads down here. It follows all the way back around. It interrupts, recalculates this. I mean, it's two levels of redstone. I really don't want to have to move the whole thing down. And except for the fact that obsidian is, I mean, it's just breaking blocks. They're hard blocks to break, but it's just breaking blocks. I think moving the obsidian, would be easier. Sir, how'd you get in here? Do you hate me? Do you hate me? How about now? Let me just look. I bet he hates me now. Let's give him a minute to fill up. See, I gotta change all this out to glass. I gotta be able to tell what's going on, how close they are. Do we have everybody out? You know. What is he doing? There we go. Okay. I love this part. I mean, it's noisy, but I love this part. Here, let me empty some of my inventory. Look at all this XP. Nice. See, I'm already back up to a level 17. That was just 10 of those little guys. I mean, they definitely throw down quite a bit of XP. Okay, let's just let them drop. I let them drop for a little while, and then I'm sure that all the others are gone. Nobody hates me anymore. Give me a minute to look this over. See, should I put a pressure plate and then a water source moving that way? Man. I think the other side looks better. Am I wrong? Is the other side flowing a little better? Oh. Look at me wandering around out here in the dark like I've got good sense. Can't see it from right here, can I? Let's try from right here. Next thing you know, those sucker fishes will drop in on me. Oh, I just knocked a torch off, didn't I? No, it's about the same on this side. I tell you what, we're going to leave the Zombie Pigmen farm. It's a little frustrating, and I'm not sure what to do next. I definitely do need to do some decorating. I'll go get some blocks, and we'll put some of this up. A little frustrated. I was hoping that raising the back by two and this one by one would let it flow down, but no, it was not to be. Yeah, okay. So if you're just joining us, let me take you and give you a quick tour of the rest of the place. Here, come on. I'll show you the golem farm, iron golems, and we'll take a look at the mining operation. Now, the mining is going really well. Right now, I'm pulling out just a crazy amount of diamonds. Raven has just joined us, Raven Dragon, and she's got a base right over there, which she's just begun, so really all we have is a hobbit hole. Now, she did start a mine right over there, pretty close to the XP farm. In fact, probably one of the things I'll do tomorrow is go and put a path in so she can run quickly from one to the other. Now I do have a short little path over here to her hobbit hole. Now, in case you're wondering what this thing is, one of the first things I did when I got in this world, because it's particularly since it's a swamp biome, was I found the boundaries to the chunk. Now, there are a lot of videos out there, so this isn't going to be a tutorial on that. But I did find the center point, I found all the chunk boundaries, and I put that... Let's turn this off. Okay, if you're just joining us, welcome back. I just had a little glitch here. There we go. Let's get this in the background. Okay. So I think what we're going to do, we're going to sign out, guys. This has been the Geeky Minecrafter. I hope you've enjoyed this live stream. I apologize for the technical difficulties. Do check back in with me, and we'll see if we can't decorate that XP farm so it looks a little better. Right now it's producing gold. I can't complain. Hope you enjoyed it. You guys stay tuned. Happy mining!